adjusting that metering valve based off of this machine.
Alright. Listen, good. We got some pretty high water. Vane position switch, which is that bad boy there. Wasn't showing closed. That still feels tight. Plug looks good. We haven't had issues with this before, and somebody has definitely replaced this at some point. So they've had issues with it in the past, at minimum. Going to compressor, to Vane motor switch, does not show close. Pre-rotation vanes show to be in zero position. We're giving it a full close command. Does our PRV potentiometer come up? I see the actuator is moving. We show 8%, 10%. We still show no switch closure. Now that we've done this, I'm gonna go ahead and go back to close, because I've confirmed that it will start, it'll show open, and we are showing a potentiometer percentage. I've verified that we are actuating.
Yep,
we're closing just fine. Everything's swinging like it's supposed to. Pretty happy with that. So we're just about there. I wanna see that Vane motor switch activate. See, now it activated. So that makes me question. All right. It didn't activate last time. I did a manual run of the motor. Now, it's possible it could have gotten out of calibration. So, oops, we come back. We're gonna go back into auto. I'm gonna just turn it off because I don't actually want it to start yet. I'm gonna go ahead and do a pre-rotation vane calibration. Questioning if that whole assembly got out of calibration and it thought it had run it to full close when indeed it hadn't. So right now it's going to run this to all the way full open, and if I remember correctly, it does have a potentiometer to monitor the position, but it should also be running off of time, and then you can't read that tag anymore, so there's no telling what that says or ever said. A PRV is the same thing as an IGV. It's inlet guide vane or pre-rotation vanes. Those are located right here on the inlet of the suction bell. That actuator is controlling those vanes opening and closing. Those vanes are what helps us control the load going through the machine. There's an impeller in there that's moving the refrigerant, and we can restrict how much volume of refrigerant is able to get to that impeller by opening and closing a set of vanes that does legitimately look like this. They've got little paddles in there that are triangle shaped, and they rotate and move and do exactly as you see on the screen there. So the more load we need, the more we open the vanes. The less load, the more we close the vanes. We can't just run them open because it will cause the chiller to surge, and we can't leave them closed because, well, then it can't load up. This machine has to be at full close, right? Centrifugals in general have to start up with the vanes fully closed. If the vanes are not fully closed and they're not seated properly, it will cause the motor to overcurrent because there's too much load on the motor when the impeller is trying to spin over and start to create some flow. So after the motor has reached operating speed, whether it be a variable speed system or a soft start, wide delta, however that's controlling the motor, then we will begin to slowly open those guide vanes to put load on the motor. That is why the PRV motor switch is critical, because that's one of the safeties to ensure that that actuator actually moved into a full closed position. We're on the tail end of the process. It already drove to full open. It stopped. Now it's driving back to full closed. It still shows the calibration is in progress. It's just about finished. It shouldn't have much longer, and then it'll be done. And that's really kind of what I'm thinking. I think we got out of calibration, or we've got a bad motor switch. Because I'm sitting here watching it, and I don't see any more rotation. That should be this full closed position, but it's waiting for that motor switch to make. Okay, all right, just finished. PRV calibration was successful. It's happy with it. I can go back to compressor. Vane motor switch is closed. We're in auto. Everything's where it needs to be. And go, go, gadget. We got our pre-lubes. During a pre-lube process, we're pulling from the sump. We're pushing through our oil filter up into a reservoir on the top of our compressor. That then rains oil down through the bearing assembly. We've got some journal bearings in there. and then it comes back out through the bottom port back into the sump. These machines do run variable speed pumps that is controlled out of this cabinet. That way we can try to maintain a specific oil differential. Right now we're running 42 hertz on that oil pump, 35 pound set point. And so our actual oil pressure is floating at about, you know, right there at that 35 PSI, which is where we want to. So this is from the main systems page. From here we can monitor our pressures, our saturations. One thing to really note is while you're in the process of starting up, especially when you've got a heavy pull down, you're gonna have really high small temperature differences, or that's also just is York's way of saying the approach value. So 5 degrees is not acceptable at all, but we're in a pull down right now. We've got really high water temps with a 60 leaving, 73 entering. As this machine pulls down and gets closer to load conditions, that's gonna go, that's gonna dramatically drop. Like even on the condenser, we've got 5 degrees there too. So don't let that spook you or get you away from yourself. It's adjusting that metering valve based off of this machine. All right. Got a motor overcurrent. Okay, we've also got a heavy load. I saw it went into limit. Why didn't it back off? Let's see, I'm gonna go, before I just turn it back on, motor current 100%, pull down, VSD, I'm going to ACC, it's ACC technically for surge, I'm just rolling through real quick. So, okay, I don't like that. So pull down demand limit, we're in a pull down, we're at 100%. I'm gonna drop this to probably 80%. Put in 80, enter. So when you're in a real heavy pull down like that, it's real easy for the system to overload itself. So typically you're gonna have a lower pull down. In some machines we have to run them as low as 60%. But I'm going to try to limit it at 80% for a pull down. And you go into a pull down once you're X amount above the set point. So we've got a set point of, what is it, 44. We're way above that. Because of that, we're going to go into a pull down mode. And while we're in pull down mode, we're going to limit and not let the machine go to 100% just for this reason right here. We don't want to trip out, because yeah, 105% is not hard, you know, that extra little 5% fluctuation when we've got a limit of 100% with a high demand is not hard to do. So once we've pulled the loop down, it's easy to kind of maintain that 100% with very little fluctuation. You're not having crazy swings. Right now we've got dramatic swings happening on our water loops, which is going to cause some significant fluctuation in the current load. See, pull down demand time, I'm going to run that to 30 minutes. So right now this display is running off of the micro board, which is the 3630. It's saying the fault condition still exists because the fault isn't living on this board. It's actually in the ACC and in the logic board on the VSD cabinet. Now I really don't like power cycling machines, so technically I can open this and there is a reset button. Like I said, you can power cycle the machine. I am not a fan. Yep, we're in fault and there is a reset right here. Okay, we're gonna hit that reset the alarm, or at least, yep, ready to start, so we should see that. We can hit clear now. Okay, so if you didn't see, there's a reset button right there. What that'll do is that'll just clear out the stored alarm, and you can see up here through these LEDs, when you see K1 enable, that means that the logic board has cleared any alarms and it's telling the micro board that we are allowed to turn on. Now that we've put a demand limit in, we're going to try start up again. We'll cycle over, hit the go button, watch her go zoom or bang, one of the two. I much prefer the zoom over the bang. We are looking absolutely beautiful. NTT guys, take care of your family, take care of your spouse. I'll see
see y'all later.